All bubbles eventually burst, and the bigger the bubble, the bigger the burst. U.S. households are now sitting on a record $14 trillion in mortgages, credit cards, student loans, and other forms of debt. That marks the biggest annual increase since before the financial crisis. According to the New York Federal Reserve, which is one of the 12 banks that make up the Federal Reserve System, total household debt balances rose by $601 billion just in the last year, which now tops $14 trillion for the first time ever in U.S. history. The last time the growth was that large was in 2007, when household debt rose by over $1 trillion. Auto loans, credit cards, and student loans increased by almost 30% since 2003. Why are Americans so in debt? If the economy's as good as we're constantly being told it is, then why are Americans not saving any money? Why don't average consumers have any cash on hand to buy things? Why do they have to borrow so damn much? The U.S. household debt numbers are out, and they ain't pretty for the 22nd straight quarter. In other words, for 5 straight years, Americans' borrowing habits have gone up without fail. The total U.S. household debt rose by more than $600 billion from last year. That means that for the first time ever, the American household debt surpassed $14 trillion. Household debt hovers around $15 trillion. The real economy is in disarray. And by the way, the borrowing is across the board. Student debt went up from $1.46 trillion in the final quarter of last year to $1.51 trillion in the first quarter of this year. And you know who holds $100 billion of that debt? Americans over the age of 60 who apparently still haven't been able to pay their college. Auto debt has now risen for 35 consecutive quarters. 11 straight years. We now owe a $1.3 trillion in car loans. 5% of those haven't made a payment in more than 90 days. Auto loan delinquency going through the roof. And how about credit cards? Americans now owe more than $1.4 trillion in credit card debt, which is up from $854 billion just 5 years ago. By the way, credit card delinquencies just hit a two-year high as well. More than 8% of credit cardholders aren't even making a minimum payment. So in all the hoopla about the greatest economy ever that we keep hearing, very few are telling you just how bloated our economy actually is. Yes, we're consuming more as we're constantly reminded to do just that. But are we doing it on borrowed time and borrowed money? This is just a giant bubble that's waiting to burst. The US doesn't produce anything, except military goods. We're just living off credit and the fiat dollar and paying off our debt with more debt. The 2008 bubble is effervescence compared to the current mega bubble, about to go blammo. Next on the agenda, jailing the poor for debt, then making the work it off while charging them for jailing accommodations. Perpetual peonage. The government is bankrupt, the corporations are bankrupt, many people are bankrupt and struggling. Yet according to Trump's delusional thinking, this is the best economy ever. Indeed, if you are in the top 1%, this is the greatest economy ever, no question about it. Trump gave $1.5 trillion to the wealthy, and now he wants to pay for it by slashing Social Security and Medicare for seniors and Medicaid and food stamps for the poor. He's doing to the U.S. what he did to his companies, bankrupting them. Welcome to the Atlantis Report. The Fed, in other words, our central bank, which is a panel of unelected bankers who decide how much money to print out of thin air to stimulate the economy because they don't think our economy is healthy enough to sustain itself. Those bankers just announced today that they're gonna continue pumping billions and billions into the banks so they can pay their loans all the way into April. This is the so-called repo market. This intervention has nothing to do with reality and everything to do with artificial economic manipulation. The Fed is creating a monster bubble, never seen before in history. You can't print free money when there's no one buying it. That will eventually become a problem, and we're ignoring it. Oh well, that's what happens when you believe in narratives instead of facts. Meanwhile, the US deficit surges 25% in fiscal 2020 and is $1.1 trillion over the past year. Yes, you heard that right, the budget deficit for the first 4 months of fiscal 2020 is $389.2 billion, the Treasury Department reported. That's a 25% gain from the same period a year ago. Over the past 12 months, the gap has been nearly $1.1 trillion as the national debt has swelled past $23 trillion. The sea of red ink is getting deeper and deeper in Washington, with the federal government already racking up a budget deficit that is averaging close to $100 billion a month. Treasury Department data released Wednesday showed the shortfall at $389.2 billion in the first 4 months of fiscal 2020. That's a 25% gain over the same period last year and already about 40% of the total deficit for fiscal 2019. Over the past 12 months, the government has spent $1.06 trillion more than it has taken in. All the red ink has brought the total national debt to $23.3 trillion. This debt level is enslaving Americans. President Trump promised to balance the budget. Instead, he gave a $1.5 trillion tax cut to corporations and the wealthy. Just one of many broken promises, but this particular one has propelled the national debt into a $3 trillion deficit. Not to mention the futile and senseless tariffs that hurt not help the American workers and consumers. This is typical for the way he runs his companies. He just borrows more money until they go bankrupt. The extension to the national debt is because he gave money on tax cuts, mostly to the wealthy. Is driving the country into bankruptcy in the same way as his businesses. Trump has been blabbering so much about his thriving economy, while he kept the country's deficit hidden, which has been stacking up significantly under his regime. I guess he will drop the bomb when he feels more stabilized. If he wins the presidency again, a must for him to stay away from prosecution. Then he will blame Obama and previous presidencies for his own failure when he cannot keep up with his broken and empty promises after plundering off all our social benefits, and also assure his own future. This does not look good. And cannot end well. The deficit will be the end of it. You can't continue to run a business without addressing it. It's so huge now and will get bigger. He's spending money he doesn't have. Billions for his wall, and he's cutting benefits for it. This isn't going to end well. To be fair, every president in the 60 years or so has contributed to the debt. There were only a few years of budget surpluses in the late 90s. However, $1 trillion annual deficits during good economic times are unacceptable. There are two ways to conquer and enslave a nation. One is by the sword. The other is by debt, John Adams. The new U.S. household debt numbers showed that Americans have borrowed higher and higher amounts of money every quarter for the past five consecutive years. Collective household debt has surpassed $14 trillion for the first time. The debt level is enslaving Americans, and sooner or later, the music stops. When the music stops in this capitalist game of musical chairs, it ends badly for some while others sit down, hoarding the massive wealth they got from those without a chair. The wealth doesn't disappear, it just moves into different hands, the same hands of those playing and stopping the music. There's no money to save. Plus, there's a bankruptcy court on every other corner now. Rich get richer. The working middle class declares bankruptcy, capitalism at its finest. This happened when the richest class destroyed the middle class. Working class down to the American poverty class and destroying the people's ability to pay their bills, including health and wealth taxes. Raising interest rates will only trigger a downturn and increase inequality via rentier extraction by finance, deepening the depression via negative reinforcement of deflation. Under deflation, you can get relative inflation if the household income falls faster than prices, as the economy and tax revenues fall sharply, increasing government debt. The 30s, for example. This is why the only solution to an economic downturn is economic redistribution and debt write-offs. This is the economic cycle, over-concentration of wealth, leading to a collapse in demand, increasing private debt and economic collapse, and increasing inequality. This depression continues until the lower orders get annoyed enough to organize and force redistribution and debt write-offs. This is the economic cycle, and why an effective organized left is essential for capitalism to work at least marginally. Otherwise, capitalism will eat itself and ensure a long economic downturn, such as in the late 1800s. Capitalism is dynamic, the rate of increase of capital with respect to time. If capital is concentrated, capital accumulation collapses, and with it, the economy, with the rate of profit falling below the rate of interest causing widespread default and a zombie economy weighted down with debt. And without investment as the falling rate of profit incentivizes hoarding. America went bankrupt in 1933, and we are owned by globalist bankers. The fractional reserve system creates money out of debt and only debt. The scam is only the principal is created, but interest not created is expected to pay it back. It's like a musical chair. When the music stops, someone is left out. Bankruptcy and failure are built into the system. Wake up, America. Time to end the corruption in the financial system. We are all debt slaves to the globalist bankers. Money is added or removed from the system by these corrupt bankers by lowering or raising the interest rate. The banking system is give me control of the money supply, and I care not who makes the laws. The recipe for world rule, and when technology reaches a certain level, they will have no need for the useless eaters. America will never pay its debts. American foreign debt is an essential robbery toward other countries. This national debt is a total disgrace. Trump gave away huge tax cuts to the wealthy and corporations. Trump blows through money, then files bankruptcy. I read he is charging each Secret Service agent $650 a night to stay in Mar-a-Lago. He is making multi-millions on our taxpayer money, while he boasts of not paying taxes for at least 23 years. He is laughing at us. Donald Trump has exploded our national debt to over $23 trillion, and counting. Our children and grandchildren will have to pay it back. And he's done it with billions in giveaways to the wealthiest corporations, while the average employee got pennies. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.